I'm engaging in AI model development at R&D Center Sony Group Corporation.
And I'm a research engineer of AI technologies at the R&D Center Sony Group Corporation.
Today, we will share with you about Sony's deep learning model. That is one of the AI technologies we develop. This AI technology can be utilized for both content generation and restoration, and makes creative activities such as video and music more exciting and creative. Deep generative models are mechanisms to automatically generate new media content, such as image, audio, text, or dialogue. As an example, let me demonstrate what images can be generated from scratch with deep generative models. Sony is developing large-scale deep generative modeling technologies, which we simply call Sony DGM. One of Sony DGM is based on the so-called diffusion models. We take image generation as an example. The diffusion models are told to gradually transform a noise to a meaningful object. At the end, we will get a new and clean image. Sony has developed a new training strategy for diffusion models, which leads to better performance. Practical images have large pixel size, which means dimensions are large. This may lead to expensive training cost. Instead, we can compress images into smaller dimensional representation. First, features are extracted by some neural network. Then, we search quantized representations of those features among a dictionary consisting of only finitely many items. After that, those quantized representations are recovered to the original image space via another neural network. This common model is called Vector Quantized Variational Autoencoder, VQVAE for short. Sony developed an improved approach of such a technique, which finds quantized representation based on how likely items in the dictionary depict the compressed image well. This new approach is called Stochastically Quantized Variational Autoencoder, in short, SQVAE. With this, we can reduce the trials of repeated training to reach the best quality of generation.
We expect AI such as DGM to become an integral part of the music, film, and gaming industries in the year to come. And knowing that we at Sony R&D have a unique opportunity to work directly with world-leading entertainment groups within these industries, we want to make the most of these possibilities. That is why one of our main research focuses is content restoration. And since we have a large catalog of Sony-owned music and movie databases, we are exploring how AI technologies can be used to revive such content, which can be beneficial to both end users and creators. Now, let me show you a Sony DGM technology which can help with media restoration. In this animation, Sony DGM can remove the blur of blurry images and thus produce a restored clean image. Next, let me further demonstrate how Sony's DGM can help to remove reverberation of vocals. First, we play the corrupted vocals.
Ask whatever, I've got answers. Why don't you open your heart?
Then, we play the restored vocals by Sony DGM.
Ask whatever, I've got answers. Why don't you open your heart?
Last, let me show you how Sony DGM can assist with reducing noise in a speech. We first play the speech before it being repaired.
It is perfectly evident that the time for an inquiry will come.
Next, let me play the restored speech.
It is perfectly evident that the time for an inquiry will come.
I hope you were able to listen to the clear difference between the original and restored samples.
Let's hear from a creator who talks about the potential of the technology we just explained.
I don't think AI was used in music production until recently, but it has started to become widely used in various ways. I use restoration technology in music production, and it helps me to concentrate more on creative activities. As this technology evolves further, it should stimulate creators' creativity and expand their options for expression.
We will continue to develop this technology that supports creators in their creative endeavors, such as music and film creation.
Thank you for your time.